It's time for us to start working on the bottom drain. So we're gonna show you the placement of where we need to put this in the very floor of the pond. My first bit of advice is I wanna get it right in the center. As you know, we dug the pond in a perfect circle, like an egg shape, and then everything is tailored down to the center of the pond. So I've measured it out. You know, we're about 14 feet across. So I'm gonna mark half of that. And then we are 16 foot long this way, which is pushing the limits a little bit. We talked about that. I'm gonna come over to 8 feet. So there's the center of the floor in the pond. And this is right where our bottom drain is going to be located. Now, the bottom of the pond is coned, and actually, if I took a level and went back, this is about where we're at in the middle, so give you some perspective, where it's about 12 inches. We're 12 inches deeper in the center of the pond floor than where the walls are connecting. So the next step is for us to dig this down. Because right here, this is where our liner is going to attach. So the pond's floor needs to line up with right here. So we're gonna dig this out, and then we're gonna trench for the pipe. We have a 4-inch pipe that's gonna connect here, and we're gonna trench this through the floor of the pond, underneath the wall. We'll tunnel underneath the wall, and this is gonna take us all the way over to our settlement tank. Now, if you'll notice, my bottom drain is, you know, about 16 inches across, and we dug around 28 inches. We're gonna dig 28 inches. So this will allow us to, once we get this down in here and level, we're gonna pour a little bit of concrete around the bottom drain to help stabilize it. In rare cases, the bottom drain can heave below the pond. If water accumulates below the pond, that the bottom drain can rise up and push the liner up. And that's called heaving. So if we put an anchor of concrete around the bottom drain, it'll keep it secure all the way level with the pond floor, right exactly where we want it. So we're gonna start jumping into this. One other tip I wanna give you is when we trench this through the wall, you know, the pond's floor is at an angle like so, it's not level. So technically we could trench in an angle to get our pipe out of the pond, and I see a lot of people do that because it's a lot of work to dig down deeper. But what we're gonna do is we want this pipe that feeds to the settlement tank, I want it level as much as possible. Imagine gravity's working below water level, things settle into the bottom drain, and then they're gonna make their way through this pipe. Now, if the pipe's at an angle, you know, it's harder for the stuff to go floating in the upward fashion. So we're gonna get it perfectly level. Things will travel down the line, and as it gets closer to the settlement tank, then we can run some sweeps and we can get the plumbing to tie into the settlement tank. So the next step is for us to start digging this out, and we'll show you how we're gonna put the concrete around the drain. If you'll notice, the bottom drain is below the floor of the pond. And if I put a level across here, you'll see it's about 4 inches low. What this is gonna allow me to do is put concrete below the bottom drain, so it'll be completely encased. One thing I do want you to notice is we do have some plumbing coming through the bottom as well, and this is gonna be for our air. We're gonna inject air into the bottom of the bottom drain, and that air will come up through this check valve, and then we'll put the dome on the top of here, and the air comes through this dome. So I want everything to be encased. I want all this to be encased in concrete, so we go ahead and dig it just a little bit deeper. Now the next thing for us to do is to run our trench for the 4-inch pipe that's gonna connect into the settlement tank, and that's where we're headed next.